Well, 17 News is your local election headquarters. We're just over a month from Election Day and 24 hours from the KGET Live Bakersfield mayoral debate set to air right here on TV 17. 17's Eitan Wallace joins us with more details and a look at who's running to lead our city.
As it stands right now, there are five candidates for mayor. One said he was surprised Friday that he qualified as a write-in candidate and is not yet ready to talk about his campaign. But we talked to the other four hopefuls, each sharing their visions for Bakersfield, explaining why they deserve your vote. Karen Goh has served as Bakersfield's mayor since 2017. Now, she's running for re-election on March 3rd. Top of her list? The economy.
I'm going to continue to embrace this community and make sure that the hardworking people of this community have jobs. Let's work on encouraging job development, both new and expanded businesses, and increased opportunities for all people.
In addition to her role as mayor, the Bakersfield High School alum serves as the president and CEO of Garden Pathways, a nonprofit whose mission it is to mentor disadvantaged youth and adults. As mayor, she says combating homelessness is a priority.
Our community has made great strides together in working on some of the challenges of homelessness, the issues that impact us with people who live on the streets. But it is together, as we work together and work on those root causes, that we truly will make a difference.
Now, she's asking you to give her another term.
Why should the voters elect you to a second term in office?
Voters have consistently said that Karen Goh has been everywhere, in all communities, addressing what is important to each of our communities, focusing on economic development, public safety, education, and being an advocate for Bakersfield.
Also running, Dr. Gregory Tatum. He is a pastor at Change Community Church in downtown Bakersfield.
And so what we must do is become more of a community of God.
Tatum believes his role as pastor would bring a much-needed perspective to city government.
A lot of people say, you know, why would a pastor run? You know, what's the benefit? You know, from a pastor's perspective, I can bring more to the table, and I think I can realize the dream of making all things happen that are possible to those that believe.
An Army veteran, Tatum served our nation during the first Gulf War. He ran for state senate in 2018 but lost to Shannon Grove. Now he wants to represent our city, first on his agenda, empowering the youth.
I want to be able to challenge our young people to get with them in junior high school, earliest elementary school, get involved with space exploration, engineering, gaming, coding, all these things that's going to take us to the next level.
If elected, Tatum would become Bakersfield's first African-American mayor, something he believes is significant.
It tells the world, it tells this nation that we have evolved as a city. When you become the mayor of Bakersfield, you become the face of Bakersfield. It's time to change the face of inclusion.
A voice for the people. We've never had that in Bakersfield before.
Joseph Caparelli identifies as an actor, movie extra, and movie producer. A former cop in Las Vegas, Caparelli says he would prioritize law enforcement if elected mayor.
They put a badge on every morning. They go to work. They don't know when they're coming home. My hat's off to them. I salute them every day. I want the younger generation to learn to wave at them and say hi because they're good people. They deserve more pay. I like to see the fire department get more pay. They work hard, very hard. I'm very proud of them.
He says he would be the city's most active mayor.
Yeah, I'm 88 years old, strong as a bull. It's always been, vote for me, I'll do this, I'll do that. And then you never see them again. I haven't met a mayor yet walking around. I want them to see me. So here comes that, here's like the guy, the boss guy. Here comes that Italian guy. There's the mayor. What the hell is the mayor doing here? That's my job. They will get tired of seeing me, because I'll be there.
And then there's this man, certified write-in candidate Mark Hudson.
I see things that needs changing.
That, he says, includes the homeless issue, an issue with which Hudson believes the city is not doing enough.
Building shelters is not the answer. You have to have to build a solution to it. Has to be some kind of rehab.
He says if elected, he would bring literally every issue to the voters before the council can take any action.
I want everybody to be a part of everything that's happening in Bakersfield. So if a decision comes up, they'll have to vote on these things. I will give my opinion, but they'll may have the final vote on everything that happens in Bakersfield. This is their city, and I want to give it back to them.
There is another certified write-in candidate in this race. His name is Joey Harrington. Now, Harrington said Friday he was surprised that he qualified and was not yet ready to discuss his candidacy. He declined our invitation to appear at the debate. And speaking of debate, a reminder, it will air live on TV 17 beginning at 7 p.m. Monday. We also will stream it live on KGET.com. Jim Scott and I will moderate. Hope you can join us. In a final word, a candidate will need to receive more than 50% of the vote to win. If nobody earns more than 50%, then the top two vote-getters on March 3rd will go head-to-head during the general election, November 3rd, 2020. In studio, Eitan Wallace, 17 News.